So Corsalite web application has multiple sides to it. Ek student side hai, ek parent side hai, aur ek institute ya entity side hai, which we call as admin. So aaj ki demo ke liye, I'll first take you through the student side and then we'll come back to the admin side. So to log in, we need to go to Corsalite's website and we enter the username and password and we say sign in. So this is the welcome page or the landing page as we call it. तो यहाँ पे अगर कोई भी schedule exam है, अगर school ने schedule किया है या institute ने schedule किया है, तो यहाँ आएगा. और अगर if there are any opinion polls, they will also come here. Student only has to click from the action bar here, from the action button to jump in directly into the test or the opinion poll. And opinion polls can be for if this teacher is doing well or not, if the class they have recently studied, have they followed it, or any kind of a poll that the student or the students need to take it. If the government wants, they can actually push out certain opinion polls if you know regarding any standardized testing, etc. Recommended reading is something that is generated with all the past history, whatever the students have attempted from day one to the current day. So this is totally personalized. So if for every student, this recommended reading will be different. This system is totally personalized. We also have, you know, it's performance based. And for everything that the student does in the system, they get rewarded. So there's virtual currency here on the top, which they can actually redeem for real merchandise. Let's get into the study center. I can click on this button. Yeah, I can click on this leaf on top. So, ye hai study center. Yahan pe aap dekhe, bahut sare colors dikh rahe hain, which are very intuitive. So each and every color actually has a significance, and the reason we did that is because we don't want students to immersify themselves into graphs and analytics and a lot of reports, because that takes a lot of time away from them, and when they're doing that, they're really not studying. So we found that there is no value for students to actually go through all this, those analytics, though we have it in the student side, which I'll show you in some time. But all that information, which performance-based information, is actually incorporated in the study center in form of colors. So when a student comes here and he looks at it, he knows that yes, I am, you know, if I, it's green, it means it's, I'm actually doing very well and the performance is good. If it's yellow, means he's average. If it's red, means he needs to improve and he's not doing very well. Blue means that the student has not been tested on those areas, and that's why it's blue, which is neutral. Let me quickly go through the navigation in the system. So as I told earlier, that this leaf is actually gets back to the study center, gets you back here. We have multiple courses here, and the reason these multiple courses are there, let's say 10 plus 2 ka jo bachcha hai, uske paas 10 plus 2 कोर्स होगा जो बेसिक एनसीईआरटी कोर्स है. उसके पास जेई मेन लेवल का होगा, जेई एडवांस्ड होगा और बिट सेट होगा. तो द रीज़न वी हैव वन स्टूडेंट इन वन क्लास विल हैव मल्टीपल कोर्सेज इज बिकॉज देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ ओवरलैप बिटवीन द एग्जाम्स. द टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस में डिफर, बट द सिलेबस विल ओवरलैप for a lot of courses. And if I am attempting something in course A, that may also be relevant to course B and course C. So I do not want that the student has to do a course from A to Z together, A to Z. But when I'm doing something in course A, that also affects my performance in course B. So I can actually analyze the student performance across multiple courses, even if he's doing only something in course, only in one course. So that's very beneficial for us to understand that how he's performing in even other courses, because there is a lot of overlap. And this is again virtual currency, where as it's accumulated, it's like a bank balance. Once you accumulate virtual currency, you can actually redeem it for some merchandise. This is a forum button. It's when I, you know, you students can post on the forum. They can make a public post where, you know, let's say from a government implementation standpoint, and when a student posts post on the forum, any student nationally can actually respond to it, and there can be a good discussion around that question or a query. There are students who are shy, who do not want to post on a public forum. For them, we have a private forum where when they post anything, it will actually go to the teachers who are assigned to answer those questions. So it will be marked as private. Then there are a lot of information on these tiles. So these bars actually show, this green bar shows here the completed topics. So within this chapter, there are n number of topics, and the student has actually completed reading all of them. Then there are levels here marked. So this particular course has level 1 to 5 questions. Again, that is customizable. You can have more or less levels based on the exam. And student needs to unlock these level as he goes. So if you see here, in this chapter, only level 1 is unlocked, whereas in this chapter, level 2 is unlocked. So in this chapter, level 3 is unlocked. So as the student goes, he breaks these levels based, and these levels break by his speed and accuracy. So as you perform better, as you get more questions right, as you become better in those subject areas, the difficult questions open up. We have multiple types of testing in the system. So one is directly at a chapter level. So these are all the subjects on top, and these are chapters underneath it. So you can directly take a test from here, from a chapter, or you can actually take a test from the subject level, which is something called the part test here. And we'll come back to it later. Then there's something called the mock test, which is actually, you can take it at a subject level, at a course level. So here, if you take it at a subject level, it will actually mimic the template set by the admin for that particular subject. And at a standard test level, it is actually following the template, which is mimicking the real life test. So as the standard test for that course will be in real life, that's how it will mimic. So it will bypass your particular level of competency, whereas all other tests which are at a subject level or any practice tests which are there, they will actually be customized to your performance, and it will actually make you break the current level that you're in. So let's say I am in level 3 and I take a test for physics, it will actually customize the questions based on my level. So the chapters I'm trying to break level 3, it'll actually give me level 3 questions. For the other chapter which I'm trying to break level 2, it'll give me level 2 questions. So all the tests will be customized. But the standard test will actually mimic the final exam test which the student will get. So this is to be taken when the student is fully prepared to sit in a real life exam. So system gives you that opportunity where you can actually take a real life exam. If you think you are prepared and very well, this is the time to take it. Then let's jump on to schedule events. So schedule events, right now there are no events are scheduled, but if there were, let's say a school has scheduled an event for a certain time, let's say evening 5 o'clock, it'll show up here. When a student clicks on it, it'll take to the countdown page where, let's say it's 15 minutes remaining or 20 minutes remaining, it'll show the countdown timer. 15 minutes before the exam, the student gets a reminder, and 5 minutes before the exam starts, he's pushed to the landing page. The exam automatically starts. The student doesn't have to do anything if he's logged into the system. The exam will automatically start, and once he's taken the exam, it'll automatically end as well. The interesting part here, and how we Corsalite is different from all the other systems available in the market, is our exams, once they start, the exam paper downloads onto the system. So that means even if there is internet breakage, there is the bandwidth is actually low, it will not affect the student's experience while taking the test. So more often, let's say in a 100 computer lab, there is bandwidth is shared. So if everybody starts taking the test at the same time, generally there is network outage where some students, the exam, they may get logged out, and other technical issues happen. But to bypass those, what we've done is the moment the student exam starts, the question paper gets downloaded on the student's device. So here, you know, a computer desktop or a laptop or a device, tablet device. And from there on, even if the internet goes down or Wi-Fi connectivity is lost, nothing happens. The student is able to progress the entire test and submit it. While submitting, the system will check whether there is internet connectivity or not. And if there is internet connectivity, it will sync it back to the server. If it is not there, it will actually check in for internet connectivity at regular periods of time. And if you log back in, it will first check whether there are any unsubmitted exams. If so, it will first sync those exams to the server. So it's a very robust system in a way where we've tried to mitigate all the issues that we would face in case of network outages, low bandwidth scenarios, etc. Next is the challenge test. So this is again a very good way for students to eliminate fear of exams, and also it keeps them on their toes. It checks their speed versus accuracy. It gives them a way to, you know, compete with their friends in a very healthy way. So you can add students here, you know, you can add your friends here, you can create a challenge. So you can say how many questions, which chapter you want, for how many virtual currency points, and you can create a challenge. Whoever wins the challenge gets some points, but there is a minimum criteria that you have to get so many answers correct and so much percentage accuracy for you to even earn those points. So the algorithm, it does not let the students scam the system, but at the same time gives them motivation to challenge and get more currency points from their fellow friends if they do deserve it. So if they are really good, they can challenge the students, other students, and get those points and build up their bank balance to redeem, you know, merchandise that we spoke about. So that was challenge test. Next is exam history. So exam history is again a place where you can actually see all the kinds of tests that you have done, be it a chapter level or mock test or subject level or any standard exam. It lets you delve down into the analytics for that particular exam as well. So when we take an exam, I'll come back to it. It also shows you what rank did you get, what score did you get, what is the status. You can actually see the exam details here. Let's say your physics 5 questions. So this is all related to exams and all the history related to all the exams the student has taken so far. Next is recommended reading. So again, as we spoke about recommended reading earlier, that it's generated based on all the history of the student. So whatever he has done so far. So some students who are very, very good, they get complacent over time. And they, let's say their tiles are mostly green or yellow. They think that they're very good in all these chapters. So recommended reading is very good for them because it lets them see that, you know, these are the topics that they really need to improve even now. So they can actually select a few topics here, and they still need to improve on these because this also takes into account their accuracy as well as speed. And you can select a few chapters here or topics. This is at the topic level. And you can actually create a test from here. So if you say take test, it'll actually let you take, customize how many questions you want in that test, and you can take the test from here. So this is again a very good way for students who are, you know, who think they're very good and they've already done a lot of revision to come back and improve further on, you know, their skills. Next is curriculum. So curriculum, or what we call micro scheduling, we'll see more from the admin side. But if the curriculum is set up, it's basically for a school or an entity to manage how the students see the study center. So, and what activities they do here. So micro schedule, they can actually, the student or the school or the teacher can actually set up what tasks the students will do, and all they need to do is go to the admin and release those tasks so the student will see them. So they can also, the differentiator here is they can also set up worksheets, which actually let, when the student is doing worksheets, we can also capture number of attempts, which again gives the teacher insight into you know, how the student is doing, whether he is understood or not. So we give a pre-hint, a hint, and then the solution. So worksheets are very interesting in the curriculum side of the application. The curriculum can also contain some practice tests, exercises, reading material, you know, for the student to do it on a day-to-day basis. So curriculum is, as you are teaching at a parallel track, you're using Corsalite as an online system, implementing the curriculum that you're actually doing in school. So it's a very good supplementary tool for both teachers and students to benefit from. So now let's get back to, let's say, let's go to physics and pick a chapter, and let's read some content, and I'll show you how, what all we have in the content side of the application. So this is, I chose rotational motion. So this is the chapter and this is the topic, and I can change topic from here at any time. This is the content which we have available in this topic. Just wanted to mention here that any content in this application is customizable. So we work with multiple contents. It's not just the content that we have. So if an entity has their own digital content, we can easily upload it through the admin and it will be available here on the student side. So we do have 6 to 12 JEE Main, NEET, and all engineering medical content available on our end, including Olympiad, KVPY, etc. But we do work with other contents as well, as long as they are in digital format, we can definitely upload into the application and work from there. Some of the other things that are available on the content reading side of things is, one is we can download the PDF. So you can actually download the student can actually download the PDF and take a printout if necessary, or the teacher can actually do that and use it as a handout in the class. We also have videos here. So this particular topic has attached videos. So you can click on any of these videos and view. We also have integration of through virtual classrooms with Google Blue Button, Big Blue Button. And when that is used to do virtual classes, the videos directly cross map to one of the topics here, and then they show up as this list. So that is an added advantage. If we do virtual classes, you can actually get all the videos attached here directly. We also can add to notes, which is a very simple way to do it. Let's say students, they make cheat sheets, or they make, they organize their notes and they take printouts for revision. So we've provided that facility. So all you need to do is highlight a text or image or whatever the student wants to make as a note and click on add to notes. So there is a snippet that gets copied here, and there's a post that is a note that is actually generated. So if you see here, this note is generated, and you can alter the note if you want here and save it. So you can actually, under rotational motion, you have these particular notes. You can print from here and, revise it on your, at your own time. So it's very, very helpful for students, because if you make notes in books or, behind notebooks and stuff like that, you may lose it. But if you make notes online, they actually always stay with you and you can always take a printout. So very safe way to use the system. Similarly, you can actually add a post to the forum. Again, if let's say I have a doubt in this particular paragraph, I can actually select it and add a note to the add a post to the forum. Again, there'll be an HTML editor that comes up and you can post it. Mark it as private if you need to mark it as private. Otherwise, just post it as a public post. View notes works very similar to add notes. You can actually view all the notes, whatever you've created, through the add note functionality and print it. Each and every topic, let's say dynamics of rotation is the topic here. So these are the related exercises to it. When you click on the exercise button, you actually, there are level 1, 2, 3 exercises. And if you complete level 1, only then this topic is marked as complete. So on Study Center, there's a complete topic bar. So that only exercise, when you complete level 1 exercises, only then that topic will be actually added there and the bar will actually grow. So I'm just going to do a couple of questions, exercise questions here. The other interesting thing about our system is that we have multiple types of questions, so multiple databases, I should say, of questions. So one is the exercise questions that you're actually seeing here. The second is the practice questions, which you actually do when you take a test from a chapter level or a part test, right? And the third is the exam level database. So when a school schedules any exam or koi bhi wo exam dalte hain sare students ke karne ke liye, those exams are actually stored in a separate database. Aur wo humne isliye kiya hai ki koi undue advantage nahi mile kisi student ko, kyunki agar ek kisi student ne pura practice kar rakha hai pura database, practice database, to agar wohi questions dobara exam mein aayenge jo ki standardized school level ka exam hai, to they will get an undue advantage because they would have gone through all the explanation and answers. To us wajah se we've kept an exam only database separate, and when you're entering questions in the admin side, you can actually mark whether this is an exam only question or an exercise question. So that specificity has been given, and that facility has been given in the admin. So that way it keeps the exam only database separate from exercise and separate from practice. So this is the exercise questions. So let's come back to the content reading. So this is part of the content reading, side of things. So let's go back to the study center. And now let's do one test. So let's take physics and let's take Newton's law of motion. Let's take a take test. So this is the test coverage by chapter graph. So before taking a test, it actually, the system shows you how many level of questions are available for this particular chapter and how many you've attended wrong, how many are remaining, how many you've attended correct. Just as a view snapshot into what you've done so far in this chapter. Here only level 1 is available for this particular chapter because I have not achieved the accuracy that I need to break level 2. So only level 1 is available for me to test. तो अभी मैं सिर्फ लेवल 1 सिलेक्ट कर सकती हूँ. यहाँ पे एक और फ्लैग है, यूज अडैप्टिव लर्निंग. सो अडैप्टिव लर्निंग इज लाइक कंप्यूटर अडैप्टिव टेस्टिंग. सो लाइक हाउ कैट एंड जी मैट आर, एज यू गो यू नो स्टार्ट फ्रॉम अ लेवल दैट यू आर करंटली इन दिस केस लेवल 1 एंड यू कीप गेटिंग आंसर्स करेक्ट, तो लेवल राइज होता जाएगा. सो लेवल 2 विल questions will start coming. Level 2 सही होते गए तो level 3 पे जाएगा. तो ऐसे करके your level keeps rising up as you get questions correct. So you can tick mark this flag if you want that feature to be enabled. So it will bypass the actual the level selection that you have done. So when you select this flag, very very critical for and very interesting for students who want to challenge themselves, who want to see and push their limit and want to check how far they can get with which level. So if you want to test your limit, you should use this. So let me take a 5-question test real quick, and I click on go to test here. सो यहाँ पे जैसे आप देख रहे हैं, द क्वेश्चन इज पेपर इज बीइंग डाउनलोडेड. तो जैसे मैंने पहले भी बताया था कि एट दिस पॉइंट इफ इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी गोज ऑफ, इट इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू पेनलाइज मी फॉर नॉट फॉर अटेम्प्टिंग द टेस्ट. सो इट द टेस्ट विल स्टिल कीप गोइंग ऑन, द काउंटर विल स्टिल कीप गोइंग ऑन. सो फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ अ टेस्ट द स्टूडेंट एक्सपीरियंस विल नॉट बी शैटर्ड. सो स्टूडेंट कैन स्टिल कीप गोइंग ऑन द टेकिंग द टेस्ट. So as you see, yahan pe on the right, you get some colors. So I attempted question 1, I got this is colored green now, so this is answered. Let's say I skip something, it's red now. If I want to flag this, so let's say I want to ask this question in class and I have some question, doubt here. So I can mark this flag and it'll actually come as yellow. So it's all colored based on how you've been in answering the questions. You can also view the full question paper here. So it'll actually show you what questions you've got. And let's go back and answer this skipped question also. And then I can submit. So this finalizes your answer paper and it will actually give you the exam result summary for this test that I have just taken. So as I said, it was a very simple test and there was physics, 5 questions. All of them were for level 1 because I still had not broken level 2 yet. And you can drill down into these and check your time and level. And if I took more time in which question and I want to go back and see that question more, I can do that. It also shows me the level of percentage correct and wrong. I can view answers from here. So this will actually show me what are the answers for these questions. And I can see all the timing that I took and what was the recommended time and all the analytics for that particular question here. Then also we have reported wrong question button here. No matter how much we try, any question database may have some errors at some point, and students are the best to actually keep the database clean. So we reward students also if they report something wrong. So we encourage them to actually report something which they find wrong. So 90% of the times, 99% of the time, students actually report something which is actually not wrong. But that's again a process of learning. So when they report something as a wrong question or a wrong option or a wrong answer, we write back to them. So we respond to each and every reported wrong question and we explain it to them why it is actually not wrong. In 1% of the cases, let's say if there is some error in the question or the option, we actually acknowledge them and then they get rewarded for that, for reporting that question wrong. So it is a full cycle. It is a learning cycle for students and also keeps the quality in check. So that was part of the take test from a chapter tile. Let's say I wanted to take part test, which means I want to take multiple test for multiple chapters. Then I can click on part test from here, and this is the recommended. These are the recommended chapters that the system wants me to take. So this is again based on my performance, and I can alter the number of questions here if I wanted. If I want to bypass this algorithm, I can actually click on all. And then it'll actually give me all the chapters available and the number of questions available in each chapter. I can customize what I want to do today, what I'm in the mood for, and then I can actually click on take test. Here also we have an option for computer adaptive testing, which means that the system will take me through a journey where I'll start from the level I'm currently trying to break, let's say level 2, and bump up the level to level 3, 4, and 5 based on my performance. If I'm doing well, it'll bump up the level. If I'm not doing well in a certain chapter, it'll bump down the level. So the idea is not to demotivate, but to motivate the student to keep doing it. So jitna student acha karta jayega, utna level upar jata jayega, nahi to level niche aata jayega. So eventually the learning happens no matter where the level of the student eventually is. So we also do have analytics here, but jaise maine pehle kaha tha, we do not think that students should be spending a lot of time in reports, in graphs, in analytics. Jo bhi unka performance hai, jo bhi we, you know, whatever they have done, it actually flows back to the system. We ingest it, incorporate it in all the colors, jo bhi yahan pe dikh rahe hain, they all are coming from the analytics itself. But we do provide it, jaise agar kisi bacche ko dekhne mein interest hai, so he or she can go to analytics and see the analytics. So again, these are very robust analytics. We have accuracy versus speed, we have progress report, we have test coverage, time management, and recommended reading. So it shows for all each and every chapter where the student is. And time management, again, it shows where you should be spending your time. So all these are complex graphs which make a lot of sense, but again, they take time to drill down, and each and everything in the analytics has been incorporated in the workflow that the student goes through in his day-to-day when he's using the application. So this kind of brings us to an end to the student side of the demo, and I will demo the admin side right after this.